This is the vegan anarchist, and in this video, it should be about why anti-IDPOL and brocialists and white socialists are the real ones who are being divisive. Let's do this. You know, one of the big talking points that brocialists and anti-IDPOLers leftists, they're basically leftists in name only and actually have conservative views, and for reasons I will explain, aren't actually leftists, like Zizzy and fucking Jason and fucking other people like that. But there's a lot of brocialists, like socialism or barbarism is a brocialist, you know, backlum anarchists. Let me tell you about why they're the ones who are being divisive, why they accuse us of being intersectionalism, IDPOLers are being divisive. You see, the crime we did was, look, we point out the division that's already there. What brocialists do is they shut out and ignore entire swaths of the working class, which is actually huge portions, if not the majority, if you include the rest of the world, the working class. Black women are about 23% likely to live around or under the poverty line, and a Latino woman is about 22.7. So really, about almost 40% are Latinas and black women there. And while a lot of the brocialists and anti-IDPOLers love to romanticize and glorify the beautiful old left before those dang IDPOLers, intersectionalists divided everybody and how united they were. But the truth is the reason why the illusion of being together was because those organizations were run by cisheads, white, able-bodied people who are typically working class. Those are the ones who typically ran many of those organizations. And they excluded women who already have, and at the time, subsidizing capitalism because of the role that capitalism profited off of by putting them into. Blacks, Latinas, entire swaths, they fucking ignored. And they had the gall to say that be including them are divisive. They have the goddamn gall. Fuck anti-IDPOL. In fact, it gets even worse. While they romanticize the cishead, white, able-bodied, working class movements, the 30 new lefty demonized only came to being as a separate entity because they were left out, because they weren't involved, because they weren't listened to by the mainstream socialists. It is, if anything, the anti-IDPOL's fault that those people exist. Anti-IDPOL is cancer and must be eliminated ASAP. Fuck sexism, fuck socialism and barbarism, fuck the anti-IDPOLs and the brocialists. Fuck them! You know, and then they pull out some shit like, well, Trump won because my working class, white working class voted for him. But actually, when I looked into it and I discovered it is bullshit and a myth. What do you mean? Well, actually, for one thing, people who vote for Trump are more likely to be suburban and white and happen to earn more money. Why? us while the fucking people who are poor didn't vote as much, and that they did need more likely to vote for Hillary. And in Wisconsin, which is one of the richest of Rust Belt, they love to parody about how Trump won. Poor people, including poor whites, working class people, were kicked off the rolls. And it's percentage by Trump when the numbers in that state was minuscule compared to the overall number that was kicked off. If anything, if those if the word for the fact Republicans rigged it, Trump would have lost it. I would bet my money on it. Just like Florida Republicans rigged shit. In fact, I'll link to you the articles below of that article about how the fucking white working class was not the beacon of Trumpism, but rather it was petite bourgeois suburbanites and cops and border patrollers who were the ones who supported Trump. But fucking white working class gets blamed. You know who that helps? It helps the white liberals. Because then you can breathe out the white working class name. It helps the porky, or well, I shouldn't call porky, the bourgeoisie, because it disables the working class from uniting. Because you'll be blaming the fucking white working class. It helps conservatives and new reactionaries. Huge swaths of political spectrum are using it for their advantage. But the reality is that what I explained, I'll link a link to the article below. In fact, there have been many instances where black and white working class people have worked together, whether it's the populist movement from the 1890s or in communist recruited blacks in the white working class during the Depression, fucking Alabama of all places, or King and Fred Hampton not only managed to have a black power, but managed to get swaths of the white working class and white people with them. And then, and I wonder why they were murdered, especially Fred Hampton, you know. Could it be because of reuniting blacks and whites? It is fact. Fascists and reactionaries depend on the petite bourgeois. It is the suburbanites who vote for Trump. The reason they love this racism is because the whole point of the suburb is to move away from those damn niggers, as some of them were called, and they kept out black people for the longest time because if they moved in, their property values were lower because, well, why petite bourgeois don't like poor black people? It is ironic. It is the petite bourgeois, the well-off, the people with large nests, the cops who support Trump, the very people who have a vested interest of racism, the very people who the suburbs exist, and now a lot of them move to the external suburbs, which because black people moved in there and fucking gentrified areas. The truth is that it's not white working class or that got Trump into power. That is poor shit as a myth. The truth is, it is petite bourgeois white fucks. And let me continue. Brocialists, dear brocialists, anti-IDPOLers, and people in general. I support you if you're white and working class, black and working class, queer, cishet, doesn't matter. You could be black, white, if you're working class, I support you. I won't ignore you. But if you're for fucking brutalist, they only listen to white, cishet, able-bodied working class. I mean, shit, shout out, solidarities to the white working class, the black working class, the disabled working class. And if you only listen, or even if you only support the white working class, or even just give lip service to every other identity that are marginalized, you might as well have your socialist card revoked, because that goes against the whole purpose of socialism, communism, anarchism, leftism. How can Brocialists claim to be fighting for the working class and being for unity when they themselves are excluding huge swaths, if not the majority of the global working class? The truth is, there aren't. The truth is that they're not being socialist. They're not socialist for that very reason. This is the vegan anarchist, white, person of color, cishet, or fucking queer, trans, LGBT, or disabled, or able-bodied. If you're working class, I support you. If you're not human animal, I support you. This is a vegan anarchist, no matter.